Oh my god, I've just found the best Adobe Premiere plugin ever made for 360 video. Kind of want to keep this one a secret. Should I keep it a secret? I'm going to tell you guys. I love you guys too much to keep it a secret, but I think it's going to really amaze you because it allows you to reframe your 360 video footage, regardless of the camera you own, into tiny planets, inverted planets, or any given viewpoint you want. Best part of all is it's completely free and it's going to take your tiny planet and reframing game to the next level. Now a warning goes out to you Premiere editors, by the end of this tutorial you will want to hug and or kiss me, so please refrain. You will need to get my girlfriend's permission and the answer is most likely going to be no, but it's worth a shot.
This plugin was made by our friends at GoPro. They made an awesome camera in the Fusion and they've made an awesome set of plugins too. You can find them by doing a quick Google search. I will also put a link down in the description to where you can download them for free. Just go ahead and open the file. Follow the prompts. By the way, these are compatible with both Premiere and After Effects. So now go ahead, open Adobe Premiere as you normally would, start a project and import your files. Again, it doesn't matter which camera you're using, and to prove that, I'm importing footage from 7 different 360 cameras. Here I took exactly the same shot with the Insta360 one, Theta V, Mi Sphere, Yi, Garmin Verb, Rilo, and GoPro Fusion outside my favorite landmark in the entire world, the one and only Sydney Opera House. So I'm going to select the first clip on my timeline, which was shot with the Insta360 one. In the effects panel, you'll want to go to video effects, and you'll notice we now have GoPro VR. Open that up, and the plugin we want is GoPro VR Reframe. I'm going to drag it over to our clip, and there it is in the effects window, and instantly you can see the point of view has changed already. It's already reframed our 360 video. So you'll notice there's a bunch of variables here within the plugin that change a whole bunch of different things. First, we have field of view, so zoom in really close or really far. Then we have yaw, pitch, roll, and smooth transition. So depending on what kind of effect you're going for, you will want to play with these. I think you guys can guess what I'm going to go for. Yep, that's right, the good old fashioned tiny planet. And there we have it. I've done that there within Premiere in seconds. Now I'm gonna play that. This is my Insta360 footage. It's now a tiny planet in Premiere. I didn't have to go to Insta360 Studio to reframe that lost tourist bumping into me. I did it right here in Premiere. How cool is that? All you need is an equirectangular 2x1 360 video, and you can apply this effect. It's not GoPro Fusion only.
And if you thought that was cool, I'm now going to show you something even cooler.
Before, we reframed our effect changing these variables, but that can get a little bit fiddly, making all these changes and ending up with the wrong frame, and you do have to tinker with it quite a bit. Well, the reason I love this plugin so much is if you select GoPro VR Reframe, you can now go over to your program window and click and drag your tiny planet. This makes tiny planet manipulation so easy and intuitive. You can get the exact right angle in seconds. You will need to go back over here to change your field of view if you want it close or far, but everything else you can click and drag. Remember, you must be in the program window and you must have GoPro VR Reframe selected.
So what if we want to add keyframes within the one 360 video clip so we can move between multiple parts of the 360 all in one seamless movement?
Here I have the video I included in my GoPro Fusion sample pack, which is a free download. I'll put a link down in the description if you want to play with some GoPro Fusion footage. But I took this video in the Queen Victoria building, which is a famous old building in Sydney, and I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to move between several points within this grand old building. So I'm going to go ahead and drag the effect over, and there we can see it's reframed. I'm going to start at the very start. So you want to make sure you're on the first frame, and we're going to click the stopwatches to create our first keyframe. You want to make sure all 5 of them are selected. So say we want this as our initial viewpoint. It starts on me, and we want to do a grand sweep over, say, to the other side of the building. To create a new keyframe, all you need to do is just drag the video, and you'll see over here, it's created 3 new keyframes for us. So we wanna get that nice and straight, and automatically it's going to transition between points A and B straight away. All right, let's create another movement. I wanna pan down and look at the people walking on the floors beneath me. So as you can see, we have 3 keyframes here, and if we just move back a little bit, we'll see we now have 1 grand camera movement. It's gone from A to B, now it's going B to C. I think I'm gonna add a slight zoom to that, so we go in a little bit closer and we see the details right on the bottom floor there. If you wanna make changes to your keyframes, you wanna zoom in really close in the effects window and make sure it's lined up with the existing keyframes, and then you just change the variables. So say I wanna go in even closer.
How cool was that? It felt like you were leaning over the edge. That was really powerful. That really shows off what 360 video can do.
I'm going to include my entire reframe sequence at the end of this video, so stay tuned if you want to see this masterpiece. If you wanted to hold on a single viewpoint for a few seconds, all you need to do is let it play until you're ready to move again. Now we select the razor tool and we cut the clip in two. At the beginning of our new clip, you'll want to hit the stopwatches again. It'll tell you that this will delete existing keyframes. You hit OK and just do that for all five of these variables. Now we're going to add them back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now we're going to move to our second keyframe. And I think I want to change the perspective to be something like this. So if we move right back, we can see it holds on the tiny planet view, and then suddenly it initiates that movement after the pause. If you want to keep your editor's clean cuts without any animation at all, we'll drag the effect back over to our clip, and you'll want to time out your cuts. So say you want to cut there, you want to cut maybe 2 seconds later, hold that one for say 4 seconds, another cut there, and so on and so forth. So we have 5 different shots there. Now we go to our first shot, we change the field of view to what we want our opening shot to be, and I think we'll start on a wide shot of me looking over the balcony. Then we go back to our second shot, and I'm going to click and drag to see what I'm looking at. So one shot, two shot. In this third shot, I turn my head and I look at something else. So why don't we cut in our fourth shot to the thing that I'm looking at. So we'll reframe over here and I'm looking at this storefront. So I've just cut together an entire sequence there from the exact same 360 shot. Can you believe I'm operating the camera myself? It doesn't look like it, but I've just created a cinematic sequence from 360 footage by reframing and using simple cuts instead of animation.
How easy was that, guys? I did that in minutes, and best of all, it's free and easy to use. I'm not someone that's confident at all at After Effects, and knowing I can do awesome Tiny Planet animations within Premiere gets me really excited because it means I can take one step out of the workflow and not have to rely on Insta360 Studio as much. I love that program, but I also like fewer steps in my workflow. And I know this plugin is going to save me a whole bunch of time going forward when I make Tiny Planet videos for YouTube. Speaking of Tiny Planets, if you want to master the art of Tiny Planets, I wrote an ebook. It's called A Beginner's Guide to Tiny Planet Photography, and it'll teach you all the best effects that will get your work noticed on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. All the links you need can be found down in the description, and also don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more awesome 360 video and photo tutorials. I'll be releasing videos really soon that will show you guys more cool tools like this one that will give you exceptional results for very little time and effort. So hit that subscribe button. Also follow me on Instagram. I'm on Facebook as well. Until next time, keep capturing your world in 360. Feel free to leave me a hug and a kiss in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video.